Namaskar, I'm Shamali Sina. Welcome to Foodie Dessert. Last 2 weeks, we couldn't upload any recipes. Apologies for that. And amar somosto bangali bondhura, tumra jara Instagram ebong Facebook, YouTube e amake bar bar jiggesha korchile je Shamali or Shamali di ki hoyeche, sob thik ache to? Sob thik ache, and that's why we are back with a spicy mutton curry called Warli Mutton curry. So let's get started. So first, in this bowl, I have mutton curry pieces. Now add in turmeric powder, red chilli powder and oil. I'm using mustard oil, but for the original recipe, it's called for white oil or any unflavored oil. So you can opt for that too. Now coat the spices to the meat nicely, cover and let it marinate for 2 hours or overnight in the refrigerator. Now next, prepare the hara masala. In a blending jar, add in green chilies, chopped coriander leaves, ginger, garlic, oil and water. Blend everything together to make a paste. Now here I have preheated my tawa. Place dry red chilies, black cardamom, cloves, green cardamom, cumin seeds, coriander seeds and black pepper. Now roast the spices over medium low heat till you get the aroma and then transfer into a bowl. When it's cool, grind them to a powder. All prep work is done, so heat up some oil. Add sliced onion, sprinkle salt and fry till the onion develops a brown color. Next, add the spice blend, followed by this hara masala and water. Now cook till the raw smell of the hara masala removed. Then add this marinated meat. Over high heat, cook for a couple of minutes. Then sprinkle salt. Give a stir and then add water. Give a stir and over high heat, let the liquid come to a boil. Then reduce the heat to low, cover with a lid and cook for 45 minutes to 50 minutes or until the meat is fully cooked and soft. In between, we need to check the meat for a couple of times and stir the meat to make sure that the meat or the gravy doesn't stick to the inner bottom of the pan. Now, you can pressure cook the meat if you wish to. And traditionally, this curry serves with rice, so you can opt for a medium thick gravy. But I'm making a thick gravy as I'm serving the curry with roti. So now turn off the heat and give 10 to 15 minutes resting time and then serve. Now this is a tribal recipe and the amount of heat was really really high, so if you wish you can add more chilies and try this recipe, it's really delicious. So give this recipe a try and do let us know what do you think about this recipe, and if you recreate this recipe, share on the Instagram, Facebook and don't forget to tag us. We'll meet again. Till then, bye.